Alright everyone, welcome back to the Comic Book ASM Artist. Today we're going to the Marvel exhibit in the MoPop Museum. So this is not an ASMR video, but I'm just going to do a tour of the Marvel exhibit. I didn't get to see it on Saturday, I went to Free Museum Day, but I'm doing it today. Alright, let's check it out. Keep uncovering these fun little statues here. Another cool Thor one, very cool. Here is an old New York newsstand here. Very cool. And these are all little dummy placard comics here. Very cool. Alright, so we see a kid in a cap suit here. Lots of old-time images of kids enjoying books. And we have a movie over there. About the history of Marvel, I would imagine. Here's the hashtag if you want to check out other people's photos. And it starts out with a very iconic image of Cap here. I believe this was in the back of issue number one for the fan club. So we get to see some more of the start of everything. See some more original work here. There you are. Just get you some more of the history there. As you all know, I'm a huge Captain America fan, so it is so cool to see. And like this image right here, blown up so large. Amazing. There's a Human Torch cover here. I believe, yes, this is an original. Very cool. And here's a page from the Submariner. Right there. And we have the first Marvel Comics number one graded. Is that 4.0? Yeah. And here is our first superhero rivalry. And we see the discussion of the comics code, the seduction of the innocent, and here are the rules and standards from the code, which I think are pretty cool. Most books today don't uphold them, but it's pretty neat regardless, and I strive for that myself. We have the start of Marvel Comics. Originally we knew it as Timely. Things started to happen. It's a picture of the bullpen, as it was known. And of all the creative talent that was there at the time. Is from 1976. Maybe that's old Stan Lee there. Another original art piece here. It's a placard. We'll write up about Stan Lee here. Flo just passed away, I believe, this year. Standard view would look like out the window, the bullpen. Some more private photos here. It's Paul McCartney with Stan. You can see it. Got some glare right there. Yeah. Trace Stewart. Here's a Jack Kirby self-portrait. Seen on a Kirby collector. And this is a reproduction of his drafts board. I know this isn't his. His was notoriously very filthy. So he worked very hard. There's a holiday card he did here. And we continue on. We see the Fantastic Four here. Original stuff. There's a copy of issue number one. Not graded, but still cool. And you see old Ben Grimm here on the couch. Statue of the Black Panther. Here's some concept work for the Black Panther. Some stills from the movie here. And we have an original page here of Cap fighting Black Panther. And then we have some of the suits from the movie. Now we've reached our Spidey portion of the museum here. Original page there. First costumed appearance of Spider-Man. Nice blown up. Fantasy, Spider-Man's first appearance. Our nice Spidey statue there. A couple more original pages. Up top we see different iterations of Spidey there. Original pages. Tom McFarlane original there. We have a Romita Sr. here, original. You can't really read that because of the lighting. It's okay. And we have Doc Ock. My favorite Spider-Man villains. A little snapshot on Steve Ditko, who drew the early works of Spidey. Needs a lot of the credit for the original creations. Amazing. For a closer look at Spidey here. Original pages here, very cool. And we have the mask of Green Goblin from the first Spidey. No damage here, pumpkin bomb. And we have his homemade Spidey suit here. There's the Spidey movie poster. And here we can see the World Trade Center there. They had to go back and remove that after what had happened. So you can see it says right here. Old film cells there from the old cartoon. We have some of it to play here. Now we have a spot here. showing the full comic process here and the finished product. This is a recent one. It looks like he just did this. It says 2018. There's some Planet Hulk there. Thing versus Hulk. Another Tom McFarlane Hulk. There. Another original piece there. Board about She-Hulk. There. A nice side image. There's our Lady Thor picture there. It's more than likely. Yes. There's Hello. We can get a better angle on it there. And then the suit from, I believe from the first door, I could be wrong. More. Another. And then there's a Loki helmet. Very cool. Tiny Ant-Man exhibit. He is right there. Maybe about a centimeter or two high there. And we have some more original art there. There's the Tesseract. Or as I like to call it, the Cosmic Cube. Here is the first Iron Man suit. There's the battle damaged Iron Man here. And here is one of the newer suits here.
Push forward to shoot.
Simulation of being Iron Man there. And then there is the briefcase for the suit. Another original piece here. A little blurb about Iron Man. Once again, we enter Captain America area. It's from the annual where Wolfie and Cap fight. Very cool here. First appearance of the Falcon. And a little blurb yet again about goings on. Or little tent poles in the Marvel history that gave nods to current history. Here we go. This is the Winter Soldier suit here. Metal arm. And then we have Cap. This big shield. Another battle damaged shield here, made from vibranium, of course. Here's the Hawkeye and Black Widow set piece here. Some more blurbs. Actually a readout. of different arrows there. Can't really make them all out, but that's alright. Pursuit here. Fury cover there. Fury suit. They had a poster of this early days, I believe. This beautiful gourd here. And we have original appearance there. This is the Guardian's wing. Miss Marvel here. Have Lockjaw. I don't know why he doesn't have his little tuning fork on his head though. X-Men number one. Jack Kirby. Beautiful. That's the X-Men a lot of people started collecting with right there. Remember, all this stuff is originals too, so it's pretty amazing that they're able to get it all and collect it here. I believe it's going to the Smithsonian after this, so. Wolverine. Frank Miller. Batteries used for that. And they have little blurbs about the Runaways. And there's little kiosks like these all over the place. So even from what you're seeing here, there is still more interactive content as well. But I am just trying to capture what is easiest for me to show you all. Another cool executioner song stuff here. Let's see, the Doctor Strange areas. Pretty trippy. This room is very disorienting to me. Stuff's going on everywhere. There's mirrors everywhere. There's Doctor Strange's outfit here. Supernatural area, Ghost Rider, Dracula. Clayton Crane there, I believe. There's the jacket from the Shield show, has Ghost Rider on it. The Daredevil area. Frank Miller there. Alex Maleev. There's the Netflix Daredevil there. There's that sign. It's a pretty heavy reflection going on here. For the iconic image here. And then behind you can see Punisher versus Daredevil there. Oh, Mike Zeke. Really see. Daredevil here. So amazing to be up this close to all the original artwork. Truly a sight to take in. It's a very large picture there. And then we have another drafts table here. Daredevil. Some more. Luke Cage's hoodie there. Digital, I'm not sure why. I think they might be doing a Jessica Jones here. That's a David Mack, I believe, yes. Very, very old cat suit here. Worn by Red Brown. Hulkbuster maquette. We have a nice big Bradshaw image here they used for the promo art for this museum. And then sure, just more video footage there, and then we might as well just throw some credits here. We made this nice exhibit. Thank you for all your hard work to make this exhibit. As a Marvel fan, I definitely appreciate it. If you want to check it out, go look at, I think it's just mopop.com. And this runs till, I think, January 6th. That's going to the Smithsonian. All right, thanks, guys. Bye. All right, I hope you enjoyed it. Might as well show you this crazy guitar tower they have in the middle. The Mopop. I see it there. And they have some Alex Ross art is out open to the public here. So even if you can't pay the extra to see the Marvel exhibit, there is some superhero work for you to look at.
reinvigoration. And in this design, I was also requested to do a composition similar to my layout design for the King Kong covers.
And here's the recent images he did, and he also did some of these in the DC characters as well, but you know, they're trying to highlight Marvel, so those aren't featured in this exhibit. This is the indie area. Just want to show off the room. Don't really want to do anything in the way of photographing anyone or anything. Very cool. And then they have all sorts of just different games you can play. They're all independent ones. Nice Mario wall for you. Omnibus back here too. Alright, I'm in the science fiction area. I just thought I would show it off a little bit. Just as a nice little bonus to you all. There's Greedo there. Lightsabers. Suit. Cybermen. Fifth Element action there. Dalek. Galaxy Quest. Your hoverboards here. The proton pack. Don't cross the streams. Little armory here of different weapons throughout science fiction. Some more of them. Universal monster, the creature from the Black Lagoon there. The face hugger. Gizmo. The Kruger. There's Indiana Jones. Actually didn't come in here on Saturday, we missed this. This is the Hall of Fame exhibit here. That's a section. They show all the, a lot of notable creatives. There's some great props. There's the Tron suit. Sword King there. nice video showing. They highlight all these different people on the wall here. And these used to be little clear cubes, but they've updated this since last I was here. So that's pretty cool. And this changes in the middle. Selects a different person each time. There's H.P. Lovecraft. That's very cool. This was not in here before. Star Trek. And I guess this is his, but it's so faded now. It says Leonard Nimoy. It's turned almost pink. This is from Blade Runner. Noting Philip K. Dick here. Script, Ridley Scott. Some Titanic cover. Planet of the Apes here. Rod Sterling. John Williams. Dune. Frank Herbert. Some Matrix for you. This is his work in here. Let's have some work here. J.G. Jones, Wonder Woman. Jules Verne. Movie I really like that a lot of people are going to care for. Stanley Kubrick. Get a little Tolkien sword here. D&D. Two other notables. There's Dorothy. Wicked Witch's hat. Conan sword there. Some more Wizard of Oz here. Princess Bride. Lord of the Rings weapons here. Staff there.
Yes.
Very cool. Some more for you. Princess of the Bride. Mm-hmm. Michael's favorite. John Cleese. There's our Ice Queen from Narnia. Finally, they have the invisibility cloak. All right, that's gonna do it, everyone. Thanks so much. Have a good day or night. Bye.